Welcome back, everyone, to Team Tinker up against London Conspiracy. We saw a bit of a base race in the last game. I missed it on the camera, but I'm getting told that London Conspiracy went for a bit of a trade. Tried to bring that game back, but Team Tinker finding some good old pickoffs and breaching that high ground, finishing the game in pretty stylish fashion. Let's see what we have in game number two. It looks like London Conspiracy have had enough of that Lycan, and Team Tinker don't want to be facing up against Troll or Wisp. So banning those out. And Juggernaut, banned out by London Conspiracy. They had that last game. It did prove to be pretty successful early on in the game. But later on, it just sort of fell flat. Got hexed up and killed almost instantly. First pick, Vengeful Spirit. Now Sing Sing. Toby and I looked at this last night when they were playing Sing Sing for the past like 10 games. He'd been playing Vengeful Spirit and Skyrath. And he's gone Venge Sky, Venge Sky, Venge Sky. And then last night, he played two games of Vengeful Spirit, completely ruining the pattern. So it wasn't going at 1-1 at 1-1. But we'll see what he can do with it this game. They haven't really been switching up their roles like they had in the past. Team Tinker do have pretty much four players who can play any role. Sing Sing has played mid, safe lane, off lane. He plays support now pretty much all the time. Koikfa was a pretty good off lane player back in the day. Especially for Team Liquid, where he really made his name after Mouseports. His Nature's Prophet play, along with Admiral Baldock, of course, who is famous for Lone Druid and Nature's Prophet, the rat style of gaming, TPing onto people and taking them down before their teammates can react. But they've brought Jirax in as their captain, who's been leading them to victory more often than not over the past week or so. And I'm just wondering if Jirax, you know, he's a bit more used to people who play hyper-aggressively. And he's got to start drafting heroes for Admiral Baldock and Koikfa to play a little more patiently, because they're not that in your face. They like the waiting game a little bit more and choosing their fights for precise times to strike. Ember Spirit and Lion picked up by London Conspiracy, and Vengeful Spirit from Team Tinker. What's their second pick going to be? I apologize for the echo. I'm not sure where that echo was coming from. Unusual. There are lots of heroes left. Brewmaster is the main one I'm looking at right now for Team Tinker. Do they take it? Or do they allow London Conspiracy to have it? Because we saw last night Team Tinker allowed Juggernaut, Wisp, and Brewmaster to all go through. And Album Sheet took all three heroes and showed them why you do not give a combo like that away. Team Tinker up against London Conspiracy. So this is game two in a two-game series in the MLG Pro League. People trying to rack up points in the group stages as early as they possibly can. We saw in the Southeast Asian League, Arcanist going down and losing their two games. Who was that up against? Began with an I. My brain is suddenly failing me. I know it's not Insidious Idol. Invasion. Yes, Invasion. That's what it was. Oh, my brain suddenly went blank there. Storm Spirit for Team Reno, Tinkerino, not taking the Brewmaster. They'd probably ban it in the second phase. I would be surprised if they did not. Tongue getting twisted, I'm sorry, guys. But they've got two bans here. Brewmaster, the most likely, and then ban out support, maybe something like an AA. But they've picked Storm Spirit into Lion, which is quite an interesting one. Lion with the Hex and the Ground Spike, Finger of Death. All able to take Storm Spirit down to low HP or finish him off in quick fashion. Dazzle Band. Able to keep Ember Spirit alive that little bit longer so he can escape to one of his defensive remnants. A third ban here from London Conspiracy. Do they ban out Brewmaster? Are Team Tinker trying to bait this out of them? Waste one of their bans on the Brew? But London Conspiracy thinking hard here. Oh yeah, Echo, you're right. Echo is only on the camera scene. So maybe the camera microphone is picking it up? I don't know, I'll check that after this game. This is going to be the final game until later tonight, where we've got some games from the Americas. We'll have Complexity going up against Wheel, and I've heard that Complexity no longer has Moon Meander. But we'll have that in about 4.5 hours. Then after that, we've got UG up against Pain in about 6.5 hours. So we've got some pretty good America's action from, again, the MLG Pro League Division 1, all happening in the group stages. What was that? A Skyrath ban from London Conspiracy. Doesn't want to give Team Tinker the vengeful Skyrath laning combo. So potent in harassing and zoning people out. And now Brewmaster. Is this your choice? Does Brewmaster just go straight through? They take out the Broodmother. Pretty nasty hero. We saw how strong that was from London Conspiracy. Didn't really hit its full potential because it was up against a Puck who could kind of nuke down those spiderlings. Bulba played very well in that lane, I've got to say, though. Face shifting a lot of the damage and keeping his own. Now, Slark banned out from London Conspiracy. Who do they pick? Beastmaster. They don't go for the Brew, they go for the Beastmaster. Something we've seen from some more sort of tier 2, tier 3 teams, especially the CIS scene, where they've been playing a roll 4 Beastmaster, stacking and pulling the camps, and then given a lane 10 minutes in or so to get that level 6, get Necro, get Blink Dagger. But he's really used for that roar. Get that primal roar off onto someone like Storm Spirit, then you've got that Hex from Lion, Finger of Death, Ember Spirit with that magical damage. You can take down any hero within the duration of that roar. Now, third pick from Team Tinker. I am still really super surprised Brewmaster has not been touched.
Axe.
And neither has Axe. That's another hero. So we saw the Lycan and Jug banned by London Conspiracy, then a Troll and Wisp, and Axe has just gone completely through. So they've now got the Axe, potentially for the offlane. Get his Blink Dagger as soon as you possibly can. Really good up against heroes like Ember Spirit. Get the Berserker's Call. Lock him in place and take him down before he can Remnant away or Sleight of Fist. Now the fourth pick from London Conspiracy here. They've got Lion. Beastmaster could be a core, could be in that offlane role, could be mid. We've seen that a couple of times from... who was it? It was the old AAA squad, like Bans and Sev, when they were still playing together in Dota 2. They picked up Beastmaster occasionally in the solo mid. It's not been really used in Tier 1 EU play. But he's got good attack animation, good attack damage. The double boar now is really good. With the Hawks, rune controlling is pretty easy. But putting the two boars on top of the ramp, if you are solo mid Beastmaster, you can just zone people out like Storm Spirit pretty damn easily. And then you move support from their safe lane roles, so they're not stacking and pulling anymore, to come and save that Storm at mid. Let's see, Team Tinker, they've got a couple of picks left. They've got two of their cores. They've got Axe and they've got Storm Spirit. They've got the jump potential there. Once Axe gets Blink Dagger and the Storm Spirit hits level 6, they can find kills pretty easily. But not when that happens. Doom, the ultimate. Pretty strong up against Storm Spirit. That's going to be the main target. So Storm might be looking towards going for a Lincoln's relatively early on. BKB not going to be too useful when there's Doom and Primal Roar on the field. What does Team Tinker pick to try and counteract that? Because right now, London Conspiracy have quite a greedy draft. They've got Doom, who needs some time. Needs to get the Devour going, get that Blink Dagger. Maybe go into the Axe build, maybe the Aura build, go for Shiva's, Vlad's, AC. Lion, pretty item-greedy support. Doesn't need too many levels, but wants that Blink Dagger as quickly as he can.
Tusk.
Team Tinker going for the Tusk. Now, this Tusk, Venge, I can't remember who I've seen it from. Probably a Russian team. But they pulled it off really well, where they had Tusk and Venge roaming around, and they'd find these little spots which weren't warded, or they'd smoke up, and they could stand on top of cliffs, especially the cliff, seeing as their dire side, if they go to the mid, and that ward spot near the Ancients, if they smoke, and go and stand up there, you can actually snowball from there to the mid hero, with the Vengeful Spirit, stun them, kill them with Storm Spirit. Queen of Pain banned out by London Conspiracy, and now the fifth ban from Team Tinker. What do you actually aim to ban here? Are you looking at Doom safe lane, Ember Spirit mid, Beastmaster off lane, Lion supporting the Doom? There are multiple ways London Conspiracy could actually run this. which is why I think Team Tinker have gone for this roaming support duo, so they can be anywhere on the map. They can find kills wherever they want to. And then in the mid game, they've got Storm and Axe to open things up, start racking up kills, get some bigger items. It makes me wonder, they're safe lane farmer now for Team Tinker. Do they have something that can just stay there for a good 20 minutes and farm? Do they go for like a Medusa? They've banned out that Disruptor, so no Static Storm, no Glimpse. Now London Conspiracy with their final pick. They need something that's going to keep them alive in the mid game. They need something not so greedy. But is it going to be a safe lane farmer, or will it be an off laner? Will it be a mid laner? They're going to pick up a Faceless Void, so they've gone full greed here. Ember, Doom, Faceless Void, really item and level dependent heroes. Beastmaster and Lion looks like it's going to be the two supports for them. They do have some escapability from the Team Arena, Tinkerino lineup. But is it enough? When you look at the four heroes from Team Tinker right now, they've got killing potential galore. They can dodge spells. Just imagine, if we see a Chrono dodge from the Tusk this game, I'll be happy. Race King. And they don't go for a hard farming carry. They go for someone who can blink in and do the damage. Someone who can join the team fights early on. He can farm up a little bit, but I think the majority of the farm is going to go to this Storm Spirit. Get Blink on the Wraith King and Axe. Allow the farm to come naturally from kills and allow the Storm to farm up. Get Orchid, get BKB. Maybe a Lincoln's, I think, up against Doom and Beastmaster. But let's see how well Bulba's Axe does. And how well this Tusk does. So they've got the Tusk Snowball, Sing Sing Venge, Magic Missile. Early on in the game, they can find kills pretty easily if they see the lion. Just see him. They can snowball on him and kill him pretty damn quickly. Here we are underway. Game 2 of this 2-game series in the MLG Pro League. London Conspiracy up against Team Tinker. Team Tinker took game 1. It's a pretty even game all around. London Conspiracy did have a pretty early advantage, and they could have won that game. They took 2 lanes of Rex, but in the end it came down to that Lycan, the Howl, the mass minions that Team Tinker amassed and sent into the dire base. Where's Bulba heading? Off on a warding mission. Is he going to get caught out here, though? Where's he placing this ward? Does it get spotted? The Void? Going to see him? Potentially? Does he wonder if the rest of Team Tinker are here? So they've got offlane Doom, who has an Observer, but it's getting stopped by Jirax. The boots first, increasing the movement speed, increasing the speed of that snowball. Admiral Bulldog on the safe lane Wraith King with Sing Sing on the support Vengeful Spirit. The Radiant Ward goes down there. That's quite an interesting one. Usually this area here, you see Dire Observer Wards go down. Radiant Wards, usually more centered towards the rune spots. So the Radiant trying to safeguard that bottom bounty rune. And the Dire going for the top one. Doom gets a decent Observer Ward down there. Going to see the movement potentially of that Vengeful Spirit and Tusk moving from top lane down to mid. They don't have smokes quite yet, but after stacking pulling maybe once or twice, Sing Sing now with a bounty rune definitely has gold for smoke. Where's he heading? What's he looking for? He's got no observer wards. Is he waiting for a gang onto the Ember Spirit? Looks like they want to at least force him off the lane. Ember Spirit doesn't want to get too close to their creep wave. Magic Missile just thrown out by Sing Sing. 2 clarities and plenty of tangos ready for him. And they know. This Ember Spirit has shared tangos, has to buy a salve from base. But he went Pullman Shield. Not a bottle rush. Bulba getting stunned up there. Beastmaster Boar a little bit annoying down here. Beastmaster? Almost missing out on that pull. I wonder if that was intentional. He didn't want the full creep wave to be pulled there. So he wants a full... That is almost perfect, actually. A full creep wave meets this creep wave. They're going to be able to deny a couple of creeps and bring it back to around this area. Deny the couple of creeps that went there. That was really... If that was intentional, beautiful play by the Beastmaster, I've got to say. Storm Spirit getting plenty of last hits at mid and Bulba. A little bit aggressive there, but we've got a faceless Void played by Madara on this bot lane. Safe lane farming. Spartan, who was the Nature's Prophet last game, going for the Beastmaster this game. Skank on that Lion, Bulba on that Axe we've seen. Kiza on that Ember Spirit, having a rough time up against Koikva, who is dominating him. 9-for-1 on the last hits, and then up at top. Relax, getting caught out, Ice Shards there. Jirang's going to body block him, Bulldog can't get in range, doesn't have a stun. He's gone for Aura and... Okay, he didn't go for stats. There's the stun. On to Relax. The Scorched Earth keeping alive just a little bit longer. The Snowball, not quite enough to take down that tanky old Doom. If only Sing Sing was there. One more hero. One more stun was all they needed. Now Bulba. Getting up in the face of that Lion. A couple of spins. Berserker's Call. Two more spins. The Lion's going to die. But he manages to back off. No more spins for Bulba. Not getting that RNG luck. Does spin onto the ball, so there's no more body blocking. No more poison attack. The Earth Spike. The First Blood might be coming. The lucky time luck from Madara. The Faceless Void finding a kill. But up on top, the Doom stunned up. Snowball. Magic Missile. Wraith Fire Blast. And he's going to burn down as well. A 1-for-1 trade, but First Blood going to London Conspiracy. Finding that kill on Bulba before the Doom went down. But still, Koikva. 16-for-1 up against 9-for-0. Ember Spirit slowly but surely coming back into this. Bottle nearly ready. And once that bottle comes, he'll be able to start using Flame Guard more aggressively. Harassing Koikva possibly. Bulba has to be careful down here. Doesn't have boots. No tranquil boots or anything for him. He's having a rough old time up against these Beastmaster boars. The Lion stuns. And the Beastmaster level 2 trying to get these stacks going. Smoke heading up to top lane. So Jirex and Sing Sing. Where is Sing Sing? Still sitting at mid. Has smoke on him. And Ember Spirit forced into the jungle. Beastmaster gets a kill down on bot lane on the Axe. Nice jump in there. But yeah, this Ember Spirit being crippled on this lane. Forced into the jungle to take down these ogres. Just because Sing Sing was standing there. Jirax finding plenty of farm and levels up on his top lane. Level 3, almost 4 now because he's been stacking and pulling. Doom trying to make the most of this lane. He devoured the Dark Troll. Does he devour this Satyr? Nice play by Jirax, just dragging the aggro back, not allowing that pull to happen. And there's a Hawk. That's not a Hawk, that's a Courier. It looks so similar to Beastmaster's Hawk. Now I wonder, Beastmaster, does he go for Sol Ring or Medallion here? Both are pretty viable options. Sol Ring will allow him to spam axes a little bit more, clear camps possibly. But here's the smoke from Sing Sing and Jirax. And this is a move that I was expecting a little bit earlier. Storm Spirit going in here. He's level 6 though. Ember Spirit in a bit of trouble. Storm jumping forward. Ice Shards blocking the path of stun. Magic Missile onto the Hasted Beastmaster. The Snowball, can they finish him off? The Hex onto Jirax. Bulba in a lot of trouble here, but the Lion gets it turned around on him. Doom. No stun left for Sing Sing. No stuns or disables at all. The Ember Spirit is the only one to die there. What a chaotic teamfight. The only heroes that don't make their way towards mid lane are the Wraith King and the Void, who are happily farming on their safe lanes. If only Bulba was a little bit more lucky with those spins. Maybe they could have found more. But Vengeful Spirit and Tusks, that's their first real rotation towards that mid lane. And they kill the Ember Spirit, which was their goal. Storm with 1300 gold. I'm quite interested to see what he goes for. Because there's the sort of old school build where you go Bloodstone, here's the Snowball though. Onto Kiza, can they actually finish him off though? That Flame Guard allowing him to survive through a lot of that magical burst which TT have. Another counter smoke, Lion and Beastmaster. Beastmaster doesn't offer too much though. Level 1 in Call of the Wild, level 2 in those Wild Axes. And that Faceless Void farming happily on bot lane. Let's take a look at the net worth actually, because we'll see the Storm Spirit leading the charge and then Wraith King with that Midas. Doing pretty well for himself. the Void needs to start catching up. Like, once he gets that Mask of Madness and then Treads, I think he'll have to move off this lane and find kills. This Storm has to die. Doom is only level 4.5. Once he gets level 6, same kind of thing. They need to utilize their ultimates to their full potential. Because right now, Bulba has left the bot lane. He's farming the jungle, got his Tranquil Boots. He's going to accelerate his farm by stacking, taking those stacks, getting that Blink Dagger. And then we see the Lion, who's left that bot lane. Koikfa doesn't have too much mana, but I'm not sure they can kill him in the duration of a Hex, because once the Hex is done, he's going to zip away. So there's Mask of Madness, Quelling Blade, and a TP Scroll for that Faceless Void, so he's already aware that he might need to react. The Snowball and Ventral Spirit, the Storm Spirit, the distance closing abilities that they have on Team Tinker. And now we see the smoke again. Bulba with a level 2 Berserker's Call, level 3 in Counter Helix. Jirax, level 2 in Snowball. Who will they find? There's no Doom up here. There's no one on this top lane for the Radiant. Place an Observer Ward, just trying to see if anyone makes their way up here. But there's 3 on this bot lane. Beastmaster, stacking, pulling. Trying to build up his way to level 6. He's going for that Medallion, not the Soul Ring. Trying to increase the damage output of this Ember Spirit and Void during that Chronosphere. And this smoke gang wasted completely because there's no one up here to kill. They could have potentially tried to go on the mid Ember Spirit, but with defensive remnants already placed, quite difficult. And Koikfa went for Treads after Bottle, looking for that Orchid. Mask of Madness on the Void. I hope that's Treads with the Gloves of Haste, and he's not going for a late Midas. He doesn't really need to catch up, he just needs to utilize his spells. He's not too far behind. And with an Ember Spirit, who needs space creating after such a rough start, the Void needs to be that creator. They have to have him play that mid-game hero. He can't be their late-game carry. Otherwise, you're just sort of carrying around this Ember Spirit, who's a dead weight. So Ember Spirit, after the 12-minute mark, will probably need a lot of room to farm that Battle Fury, where Void will be running around, trying to kill people with Mask of Madness, Treads, look for Maelstrom, try and go for that magic damage, and increase attack speed output. So when you've got increased time locks, and increased damage in that Chrono, Bulba cutting it close there, taking a lot of damage, using Berserker's Call so it doesn't take any more, and Sing Sing stacking further. 55. There we go. Ember Spirit. Just trying to burn through a bit of Koifa's HP. And a level 4 Beastmaster finishes off that Medallion at long last. Top tier 1 tower. Admiral Bulldog with Midas, Treads, Quelling Blade. 720 gold. Is there something on the way on the courier? No, that's going to be an urn for Jirax, or the majority of it. And Sing Sing gets doomed up here. Wave of Terror onto the Doom, reducing his armor to -3. But in comes the Ember Spirit. Quick and easy kill for them. One ultimate used, one TP. Not too much expended. Storm Spirit does get a bit of damage in on that tier 1 tower, but they're looking at tier 1 pressure bot themselves. So now Bulba with an axe. How far away? 900 gold away from that Blink Dagger. And that's going to be pretty key. Because once he gets that Blink, that just opens up the entire game from Team Tinker. They blink in with the Axe and Berserker Call someone, then a Storm Spirit can zip across, Vortex, lock them in even longer. They do have to worry about the reactional play from London Conspiracy, with a Chrono, the Primal Roar. But Beastmaster, barely level 5, never mind level 6. Chrono hasn't been used yet. And then the Doom, level 6, still trying to find his way in this game. Does he go for Blink? Does he go for a late Midas? Might be an option for him. I don't think it is for the Void, but definitely for the Doom. A late Midas might be a way back in. And then you go for the Aura build. Go for the Vlad's AC, Shiva's. Build up as much armor as you can. Because Team Tinker are mainly dishing out physical damage. You can stack up that armor. You can reduce the amount of damage they're incoming. quite a slow start to this game. Both teams just sort of farming their cores. I think Team Tinker feel a lot safer in the fact that they've won their lanes. Bulba nearly has Blink, and they're all getting ready to hit this timing. London Conspiracy sort of a little bit worried about what's going on. They probably feel safe in the fact that Faceless Void has had free farm on his bot lane, has Masked Madness, has Treads. But when the Beastmaster hasn't hit 6 yet, and it's 12 minutes into the game, Lion the same thing, they've got no items on them. The supports are looking worse for wear, the Doom hasn't had such a great game. And there's always that surprise factor from the Snowball. The swap when Venge hits level 6. There's so much displacement abilities from Team Tinker, where they can close the distance, get into the middle of team fights, swap people out, and now blink from the Wraith King at the same time, pretty much, as Bulba gets his. So we're going to have the double blink from the tanky melee cores. We'll have the Storm Spirit Ball Lightning. The Chronosphere, though, finally used from that Faceless Void, finding a nice and easy kill on the Storm Spirit. Also denying the rune, allowing the Ember Spirit to take it. So that does put a damper on things. He's still well on his way to his Orchid. And now Bulba has Blink. As soon as Storm Spirit respawns, it's time to go. Where does Bulba make a move, though? The Courier bringing in that Blink Dagger. Do they look for the Ember Spirit? I think that's the main one. They know Chronosphere is down for a good minute and a half now. But how do they make their way into the jungle? Especially with things like Beastmaster Hawk watching over them. I wonder, has that Hawk? No, it's got pretty limited vision. I don't think they've seen it. They definitely haven't seen that smoke. So Jirax and Bulba ready to go. Quick for heading down towards this bot lane. And this is who they're looking for, the Ember Spirit. Mask of Madness used by the Void, just farming up the jungle. There's a DD rune down here, and smoke up from the Beastmaster and the Lion, looking for a counter gank somewhere. But it's far too late. Berserker's call in on the Ember Spirit, no Flame Guard to save him. Vortex and the Culling Blade to finish him off. The Beastmaster and the Lion, nowhere near the Ember Spirit to try and save him. Might find a kill on Sing Sing, who is caught out in no man's land, but just a little bit too quick. They don't actually find him. Now the Blinks, Bulldog and Bulba. Pushing onto this tier 1 tower, Doom still making his way back in, nearly has that Midas, the counter up Midas for him. Get up to level 11 and 16 as quickly as you can, but also accelerate the farm. Accelerate his GPM to try and get that next item, probably Blink Dagger. And then most likely into something like an AC, maybe a Shiva's. Madara on that Void, DD runs out. Doing some damage to that tier 1 tower, but in comes the Wraith King. Wraith Fire Blast to stun it off Berserker's Call. The Chronosphere lands, and then a Hex onto Bulba. They try and turn it around. Nice Earth Spike there. Searing Chains. Bulba going to go down to the nuke damage from London Conspiracy. The Snowball catching Lion. He's got no mana left. Nothing to stand on. But now the Ember Spirit fighting up against Admiral Bulldog. He has one remnant left, but he's got no mana to throw it out. Bulldog will go down. But he'll respawn straight after. Koikva jumping across, finding the Ember, finding the Doom. And they're going to find another, one more kill. The Snowball bringing Bulldog in closer, who now blinks forward aggressively onto this cliff, looking for further kills. They lose the Axe. But they take down the Doom and Ember, plus the Lion. All of a sudden, Team Tinker rushing out of the gates. And now Void. Chronosphere on cooldown for a good 80 seconds. He's nearly got his Maelstrom, so that's Master Madness Maelstrom. Jirax just throwing that Snowball onto that boar. He's had enough. Roshan is a possibility here from the Dire. They've got one level up in Vampiric Offering. They've got Sing Sing with level 4 Wave of Terror. And is that Orchid complete? Yes, it is. And Sing Sing has a Medallion. They've got plenty of gold coming in on all of these heroes. Item-wise, Double Blink Dagger, Orchid, Medallion, Urn, Net Worth, that one fight takes them from a 2,000 lead to over 5,000 gold lead. Experience, same story. Sort of jogging along, slight gold lead from their laning phase, and all of a sudden one fight, and now LC looking for a turnaround. Earthspike, Wild Axes, the Void jumps in, takes down Sing Sing. Not really a big kill, but it's a nice bit of gold in their pocket. And if they can find someone like Koikva, who's running around invis right next to them, one sentry, one misstep, and Koikva goes down. Like, if he blocks that line, the sentry goes down. Oh, Koikva, that was close. That was close. Lion looking for a ward in this area. I'm not sure if he did get body blocked there by the storm, or if he was just looking for a ward. Either way, Koikva nearly getting caught out. Beastmaster's level 6, he's got that primal roar. So now they've got the ability to lock down the storm and nuke him down. As long as the Finger of Death is ready, which it will be in 10 seconds, these two heroes are a decent roaming duo. They've got enough magic and physical damage between them to take down heroes like the Storm. Ember Spirit. Running back to base. Koikva and Sing Sing not able to find him. And Bulba looking for that blade mail after the Blink Dagger. There's a bunch of heroes from LC looking for him though. Time Walk across from the Void is going to clear up this camp. Bulba pretty much unaware of what's going on, one camp across from him. Little Hawk will scout things out, see if anyone TPs to this tier 1 that they can jump on them with the Chronosphere. It looks like it might be Roshan time. Deciding not to. Radiant Ward there, spotting that courier coming across. And it looks like Koikva just pushing that bot lane. They know that there's a couple of heroes up on top, getting ready for that tier 1. No Battle Fury straight off for the Ember Spirit. He's going for a Manta. Interesting choice. Usually you see the Manta style on Ember Spirit to get out of things like Skywrath Silence. I guess they've got the Orchid on Storm, which is pretty rough to deal with. So it's a decent option. Definitely a better option than BKB early on in the game. It gives you nice armor. Gives you extra damage in that Sleight of Fist. So Manta into Battle Fury, probably going to be his route of items. Storm Spirit picks up the Aegis the Immortal. He's going to be able to zip in, expend all his mana, burn his HP, and then come straight back to life. He even found a regen rune, so he's just zipping across onto these creep waves. London Conspiracy trying to find some kind of trade-off, so tier 2 bot being pressured of theirs. And they're just going to try and do some damage onto this tier 2 up top with two catapults. It's going to be more than some damage. They're probably going to take this down. Admiral Bulldog with a blade mail after Blink. Slowly making his way up here. So are we going to see TP reactions from Team Tinker? Because Bulldog is really far forward. Blinks, doesn't get the stun. Oh, Ember Spirit TP's out. The stomp from the Doom. The Lion going to make it out. But I think the Doom might fall here. Storm actually finds a kill down on bot lane. Will die for it. The Beastmaster TP'd out. And now the Storm stunned up. Bashed. Fingered. And the Doom looks like he TP'd out fine. And now the Tusk tries to TP and gets first hit bashed by that Faceless Void. So not a good trade-off at all there from Team Tinker. They didn't find that opening stun onto a hero from Admiral Bulldog up on top lane. Koikva didn't TP there. He went for the Beastmaster kill down on bot behind the tier 2 tower. And then the Void came in. Chronosphere locked him in place, killed him once. Then the Lion with the Impale and Hex, Finger of Death. Way too much damage for Koikva to deal with. He ushered for the Ember Spirit, so he's well on his way to his Manta style. And Doom, what are you saving up for? Blink Dagger. Phase Midas Blink, pretty standard for offlane Doom. His next item choice is probably going to be the more interesting one. You don't usually see mech after phase on the Doom. More likely going to be something like Aghanim's. Maybe a Plate Mail and then decide whether he wants to go for AC or Shiva's. He does need to tank up a bit though. He needs that armor. I think Plate Mail is probably a good item choice regardless. And then if you want to go for Aghanim's, go for it after the Plate Mail. Storm Spirit still jumping around, finding farm. Is that going to be a Lincoln's from him? I really hope it will be. Really susceptible to all of that nuke damage after the Primal Roar. Sm- Smoke from London Conspiracy looking for something, expecting Team Tinker to just go straight onto this tier 2 tower. It looks like that's what they might just do. Admiral Bulldog has his ultimate. Will pop that smoke, sees the Doom, blinks forward. Who's he catch? He catches the Ember Spirit. Where's the rest of his team though? There's no reaction from Team Tinker. He's just creating space. Wave of Terror forcing London Conspiracy to go in. There's the snowball, saving a couple, but Koikva has been caught in that Chronosphere, bashed up, killed by Madara on the bench on the Faceless Void. Sing Sing gonna try and swap his way out of this danger. And Admiral Bulldog still has reincarnation. They killed the Doom, they lost the Storm, but now they're gonna go for more. Beastmaster stunned up. There's the call. The Culling Blade after the Blade Mail. And the snowball catching the Faceless Void. Does it go far enough? Not quite. Jirax didn't have the distance to find the void, so a 2-for-3 change. Losing the Doom straight off the bat, then the Lion and the Beastmaster. If that Storm had been alive, boy, Team Tinker would have run away with that fight. But good use of the Chrono there by that Faceless Void, going straight for that Storm, knowing he is the key hero. Admiral Bulldog can blink in and do all the damage he wants, but if that Storm is dead, they can't really clean us up. Blink Dagger on Jirax. Interesting item choice. I guess it can blink forward. Snowball. And how's Ultimate Progression doing for the rating side? Not too much for the Lion. Still trying to save up that 2,250 gold for the Blink Dagger. Still warding and everything. Void, BKB, defensive item for him. Pretty good up against that Tusk. But still, there's things like Berserker's Call. Swap. There are skills that go through that BKB. And Ember Spirit scrambling to get his big item. Sing Sing with Medallion and Tranquil Boots running around, doing the same kind of thing Lion is, warding up, keeping that vision going. Storm Spirit. He needs to farm. He needs a good 4 or 5 minutes just to get that gold flowing, get back into the swing of things, finish off Lincolns. Because while he's doing that, the rest of his team can fight. They can blink in like this. Admiral Bulldog looking for an opening onto the Ember Spirit. Gets mana drained. Berserker's Call from Bulba. Catching the Lion. The Roar onto him. The Wraithfire Blast. The Chrono. The Snowball. Who's he going on? Going onto the Void. The Void has no jump. Walrus Punch going to take him out. The BKB going to keep him alive a little bit longer. But there's the Berserker's Call going straight through. Catching two heroes. Doom and Void. Both caught out. The Finger of Death takes down Axe. Bulba falls. But the Void escapes. Doom has brought back, so now Team Tinker, time to back away. But Bulldog, with reincarnation still going in, kills the Lion. And a buyback from the Doom, meaning almost nothing. The Blink Dagger, he's got ultimate. Where's the Storm Spirit? That's who he's looking for. The Snowball by Jirax, keeping Admiral Bulldog alive a little bit longer. Still going to go down to those wild axes of the Beastmaster, though. Can Doom find this Storm Spirit? Can he get that ultimate off? Even if he does, they've still got no Chrono, they've got no Roar. They don't have any of their big ultimates to actually lock that Storm in place. They can stop him from dishing out the damage. And Admiral Bulldog calls out here, pops his Blade Mail, gets slowed down, and first it bashed. Snowball, who's it brought in? Brings in Sing Sing, catches that Spartan. The Beastmaster going to go down pretty shortly here, but the stomp from the Doom, catching Jirax and Sing Sing the Doom onto the Venge, taking him down. And all of a sudden, Team Tinker go back into a fight, which they really shouldn't have. Koikva went to bot lane. He was nowhere to be found. And Jirax and Sing Sing think, oh, we can kill these guys. It's fine. London Conspiracy finding a little bit of gold the way back into the game, possibly. Mandastar nearly done for that Ember Spirit. 25 minutes into the game, though. He's so far behind. And overall, team-wise, there's a 5,000 lead for Team Tinker. Nothing massive. XP-wise, same kind of thing. 5,000 lead, dipping slightly back to London Conspiracy after that fight. But item progression-wise, it's all down to TT. They don't really have a hard carry for Team Tinker. They've got lots of mid-game sort of semi-carries. The Axe, great at brawling. The Storm Spirit, if they can get the Wraith King and Axe on the front lines, dishing out damage. Soaking up spells, most importantly, then sure, the Storm Spirit can carry them through this. But when you're looking at Ember Spirit and Void, the longer this game goes, the more LC get back into it. they have managed to create space with the Void. They've used Chrono really well. They've given Ember Spirit some room to farm. He's 2-3-8 after having a really rough laning stage. They are losing map control, but it's not that bad. And now they've got a blink on the Beastmaster. So they can blink roar this storm, follow it up with a Chronosphere, finish him off with a Finger of Death. The constant vision from these Hawks. Really useful for the Radiant side. London Conspiracy trying to claw their way back into this. Doom with 1,000 gold. Is there something on the courier for him? Hyperstone. But is that for the Void? That is for the Void. Mask of Madness popped there by the Void, just trying to run down this lane a little bit quicker. Now Bulba trying to finish off that Aghanim's. And Bulldog running down mid lane with Sing Sing. We haven't seen too much from Koikva, but he's got his Lincolns now. So they've managed to finish that big key item for him, really. Roshan respawns in 30 seconds. Admiral Bulldog on the front line, so this is where they want to be. They want to try and bait in as many spells onto Bulldog as possible. Follow up with Axe. Then the Snowball. They've got so many ways to get into the fight. But once they're in, how do they get out, mate? Bulldog blinks forward onto Spartan, then the jump, the Orchid, onto the Beastmaster, taking him out instantly, jumping back. Koikva does not want to get doomed in that situation. He does have the Lincolns, but if that gets popped, he'd be royally screwed. So now Wraith King, with that Blink Blade Mail Maelstrom build. I wonder if they start to transition him into more of, you know, the hard carry. Go for some bigger items. Does he need a BKB? Because if he gets hexed up and stunned, then you rely on the Axe and the Storm Spirit to follow up. But I guess if your plan is for Admiral Bulldog to bait those spells, then that's fine. Don't get a BKB on him. Just let those spells happen. Let him die that first time, then follow up with the rest of your team. Mjolnir finished for the Faceless Void. Madara there. Pretty neck and neck with that Wraith King in terms of net worth. Admiral Bulldog going forth looking for openings. But there's nothing to be found. London Conspiracy farming top lane with the Faceless Void. Farming their jungle with a Doom. The Lion sitting behind. Lion nearly has Blink Dagger on top of this. Looks like they're going to try and TP back, reactionary. Can they defend this tier 2 tower though? Void, going to time walk back, doesn't want to put himself in harm's way. And once again, Admiral Bulldog just walks up to the tower, starts hitting it, he doesn't care. Cast spells on me, jump on me, use everything you can. Because that means Koikva has free reign in these team fights. It means Jirax can then snowball Bulba in, use the blink. Who's that a swap onto? The Lion get caught out, but now the double searing chains onto Bulldog and Bulba. The Axe gonna die. Admiral Bulldog shortly after. Now the Storm gets doomed. The Lincolns is to be popped. This is disastrous for TT. Wraith King gonna respawn, but where's his team? There's no one left to support him. Big jump in there from London Conspiracy, finding the perfect pickoffs. I didn't see who popped the Lincolns from Koikva, but the Doom straight after. Great play. And that is not a fight Team Tinker wants to lose. Giving the Ember Spirit more farm, giving him more gold and items, giving the Void space to push down this mid lane, maybe take tier 1. Roshan is now open and available for them. But 30 minutes in, this is the time. This is where London Conspiracy says, hey, we've got two pretty heavy hitting carries. We've got Doom, who can take Storm straight out of the team fight. He's going for Aghanim's. Then we've got Beastmaster with a Primal Roar. What can Team Tinker do up against us when it goes late game? Sing Sing has plenty of minus armor. Pretty good up against taking Roshan. But in team fights, what does Sing Sing offer you? A swap defensively? A stun up against these targets? Not really the most useful. Koikva on that Storm, looking forward, trying to find someone. The Doom just a bit too elusive for him, and Spartan. Oh, if Koikva had put down a remnant in this area, he would have spotted that Beastmaster down. Team Tinker trying to push out these lanes. Bulba nearly has his Aghanims, reducing that cooldown, increasing the threshold. Pretty good up against heroes like Lion, because a couple of spins, a couple of hits, brings him down to the threshold for that Culling Blade. Jirax brings creeps with him, because why not? Like, hey guys, we're doing Roshan, look, I'm going to bring your creeps here. Hawk will go ahead and scout that out, but it's already fallen. No real contest there from the Radiant. Koikva spending a lot of his mana actually, jumping forward, going down to about 750. Now Doom has no buyback, but he's got Aghanims. If they can pop that Lincolns as Storm finds a kill on Lion, poor old guy. There's no real escape from Koikva's Storm if you're a little Lion. That was one kill? That's quite a lot of experience for a little Lion. So where did Team Tinker go from here? Because pushing that tier 2 wasn't the move. It really didn't go the way they wanted to. It's kind of a hard place to fight because this tier 2, quite a small choke point. You can't really, you know, loop around and find openings this way. There's no opening here. It's all cliffy. So you do really have to go head on down the lane. Unless you want to put Admiral Bulldog there and pretend you're behind, but in fact smoke up and come round and then find a pick off here somewhere. That could work for Team Tinker. I just think they need to use these blink daggers, use the snowball a little more effectively, but bait Admiral Bulldog a lot more than they have been. He did go for the BKB, so he doesn't want to get Hexed and stunned up as much as he has been. Ember Spirit, though, 33-minute Battle Fury after the Manta style. It's going to be difficult for Team Tinker to push up high ground. Earth Spike from the Lion, and Admiral Bulldog just walks straight up. Ember Spirit dishing out quite a lot of damage there. And now Jirax, signaling, let's go bot lane, guys. We've pushed top lane in. There's no real way to push in here. Again, top lane, pushing in when you're dire is really harder at these pretty small choke points where you are just running into that high ground. Whereas bot lane, look at all this. There's all this space off to the side where you can concave around, have your hero spread out. You're not all caught by a chronosphere. Have hero standing up here. It's much easier to push bot lane than it is top lane. The same story is the opposite. Top lane, easier for the Radiant. Bot lane, quite a bit harder. It's not as pronounced, though. You do have some space off to the sides. But Radiant-wise, that's a pretty tight area. London Conspiracy looking for that smoke going into the jungle. Not expecting Team Tinker to actually go bot lane. They thought, okay, they backed off. They'll go and farm that jungle. They'll probably push down mid. Seems like a natural move to do. Now they're looking to actually breach. Ember Spirit sends forth his illusions. But Admiral Bulldog on that front line, taking a lot of damage from that Battle Fury Ember Spirit and the illusions. Not to be trifled with. Look at that, dropping to about half of his HP. He's always got Reincarnation available. So he shouldn't be too worried about sticking around there. But look how hard it is to actually get up at the high ground for Team Tinker. With that Ember Spirit just spamming out Sleight of Fist. The splash damage from that Battle Fury, cleaving around. Koikva, another ultimate orb. Probably a Hex for him. Try and lock down that Ember Spirit or Void before they can get their spells off. And Jirax, Sanj. So since, no, the Void has a BKB. So interesting choice there. If he's going for Halberd, I'll have to wait for that BKB of Void to wear off before he can activate that. Team Tinker, what's their decision? Where do they go? It seems like they're sort of caught between a rock and a hard place. If they keep on farming, they're allowing the Void and the Ember to farm. If they go high ground, they're just going to get cleaved to death. They need to find a team fight somewhere in this area here. If they find a team fight there and then go for high ground, it's going to be so much better for them. At least force buybacks and find an advantage that way. The blink forward, the Hex, the Lincolns, and then Quick for jumps away. No time for a Primal Roar. And then they had the Faceless Void ready to jump in on top of it, if they did land those skills. Admiral Bulldog has full vision pretty much of this Doom. But Doom has already backed off, not going for further creep camps, heading down towards bot lane. But that's where Jirax and Bulldog are going now. And this is where they want a team fight. But there's only two of them here. If the rest of Team Tico were here, I'd say sure, go for it. But Void looking for the jump and Chrono. Not going to find anyone. If only he knew Jirax was standing right there. Ice Shard's thrown. Blink's back. And Quick Fast Hex. So that's an opening in these team fights. That's a way to lock down one of these key heroes from London Conspiracy. Long enough to actually kill a couple of, like, people like Doom. People like Ember Spirit. Otherwise, you've got these elusive heroes like Void and Ember Spirit jumping around in team fights, using Remnants, using Time Walk, using Chronosphere. Their spells are so good. They're just staying alive that little bit longer, dishing out that little bit more DPS. Allowing time for the other one to maybe find a kill. Jirax and Bulldog trying to find that Ember Spirit who just Remnants back. And this might get turned on them. Beastmaster is waiting. Considering the roar, puts the medallion effect onto Bulldog. But decides better of it. Doesn't know where the rest of Team Tinker are. If Bulber and Storm Spirit were waiting in the wings there, could be pretty detrimental to actually go in onto the Wraith King. But Team Tinker right now just pushing gold into the pockets of the Radiant. Refresher for Void, not going for another big DPS item, wants the double Chrono. If you can lock down that Storm for long enough, take him out of the fight. Force him to buy back. Because that is a big portion of Team Tinker's damage output, Storm Spirit. Especially if you can kill him before he uses that Hex. Again. Oh. What? Ember Spirit got Hexed but also used the Remnant to get out? I don't know if that happened at the same time. Snowball there. Keeping Admiral Bulldog alive a little bit longer. The Doom has been used on him. There's the Walrus Punch onto the line, but the Faceless Void kills the Wraith King. No ultimate for him, and now Bulba caught out. What is Team Tinker doing? Throwing lives away one by one. Well, I thought they were fine there. But instead of bailing out, they decided to try and go in. Quick for killing one of those Hawks, but London Conspiracy. Team Tinker doing well, farming Radiant and Dire Jungle, keeping that gold going. But item progression-wise and actual team lineup-wise, they're not looking too good. The Wraith King getting picked off. The Storm jumping forward. Hex onto the Void. There's the Walrus Punch. They finally managed to find a kill. But can they turn this into something? Can they go for more? Roshan isn't alive. He will be soon, though. They're going to walk in there. That is like perfect timing. Usually what I see is people walk in and then walk out 2 seconds later. Roshan respawns. This, though, Team Tinker, finally something working out for them. Going into the Rosh pit as he respawns. And there's no answer for this from London Conspiracy. Team Tinker still have to worry about pushing up high ground. Bulba hasn't really had an effect in this game for the past 15 minutes or so. He was really good at finding the Ember Spirit, getting that call off on him. But he was mainly a conduit, allowing the Wraith King and the Storm Spirit to actually get there and do damage. He was just used for that Berserker's Call. Maybe a Culling Blade at the end to finish him off? But he's not really a carry that Team Tinker need. Wraith King now has Mjolnir on top of the Blademail BKB Blink. And Storm Spirit's going for a Bloodstone. So they've got a Hex, they've got Orchid, they've got ways to lock people down, silence them up. They've got plenty of initiation power, plenty of staying power. But it's just the fact that London Conspiracy have the Void and the Ember Spirit. They've got the Doom. So Koikva hasn't been able to show his face in these fights. He's had to stay at the back with Vengeful Spirit, who's ready to swap people out. And the timing has never quite been there for Team Tinker. Maybe they can see if this timing hits. Admiral Bulldog just farming that Radiant Jungle again. They're making the most out of this. They're pushing in lanes. They're farming the Radiant Jungle. They're trying to choke hold as much as possible. London Conspiracy rely quite heavily on item progression right now. So if they're stopping the Daedalus from Ember Spirit, they're stopping the next item from Faceless Void, whatever that might be. But they're going to smoke up. Who do they go for? Where do they go? Radiant? Do they go for Dire Jungle? They've tried this before. Haven't found anyone. The Ember Spirit will go back down to this bot lane. Just keep that pushed out. Don't give Team Tinker an opportunity to say, hey, look, there's no one here. We can do damage to Tier 3 tower. But it doesn't look like they'll find anyone. Oh, Bulba blinks into the wrong camp. He's got no escape now. Void jumps forward. Chrono onto him. Mask of Madness activated. Doesn't even need the rest of his team. As he quickly takes down that Axe. Now Snowball from Jirax. Who does he have with him? Admiral Bulldog is the name. Spartan taking plenty of damage. The Void does use that Refresher Orb. No mana left, though, to use that second Chrono. BKB is ready. He can BKB up. Spartan's going to go down to the Storm Spirit, who jumps across. And now the Void trying to escape. And it looks like he'll be just fine. 41 seconds without the Beastmaster. Big ultimates expended by the Radiant. There is another Chronosphere because of that Refresher Orb. Doom still has his ultimate as well. But Team Tinker haven't really expended too much apart from a death on the Axe. Now Koikva jumping so far forward. The BKB is forced, but there's the Hex onto the Void. Can they finish him off? They can indeed. No backtracks for you. And now the Doom caught in the Ice Shards. Jirax with the plays, catching him out of the Earth Spike. And then the right clicks from Doom finishing him off. The Ember Spirit trying to catch as much damage as he can onto the Storm. Doom and Void have buyback. And Koikva is still doomed up. He does have the Aegis Immortal. Can respawn. Admiral Bulldog getting his mana drained by that lion. The buyback from the Doom forcing Team Tinker back. Storm Spirit jumps in. Hex onto the Beastmaster. The Orchid then onto the lion. He's going to respawn. The Lincoln's has popped. The Wraith King has already killed the Beastmaster. And now Admiral Bulldog, Blade Mail on, Lifesteal going from that aura of his. Double respawn here from Team Tinker, Earthspike onto Bulldog. And Void respawns. Storm Spirit zipping back and forth. Void has the jump, has the chrono. Who's his target? He needs to kill the Storm. He needs to catch the Vengeful Spirit as well though. He's going to jump in and catch the... Oh, he doesn't even catch the Storm. Quick for zipping out. Sing Sing swapping his ally out. But now the Void caught between a rock and a hard place as Bulba blinks in. Berserker Call. No time walk for you. The buyback into dieback. The Culling Blade after Hex. Ember Spirit, the last one standing. No buybacks remaining for London Conspiracy. Team Ticket finally breach high ground. Finally find a way into the base. And it looks like they might take this in a 2-0 sweep up against LC. Ember Spirit trying to do as much damage as he can up against these guys, hammering away at the racks. But it looks like they'll just head over towards the tier 3 at mid. There's no buybacks from LC. There's no answer whatsoever. Creep wave pushed in by Koikva. Searing Chains just trying to hold them back that little bit longer. Beastmaster with the Primal Roar. Blink. Ready and primed. Admiral Bulldog has reincarnation. But Jirax blinks forward aggressively. Ember Spirit, you want to Sleight of Fist this? I'll stand right next to your remnant. See where you go now. Now the backup from Team Tinker. They take two lanes of Rax. That all came from a pretty nice engagement there. Koikva with the Aegis of the Immortal, allowing them that little bit more breathing room in these team fights. Because without that, he doesn't have the opportunity to just zip in, expend mana and HP, bait in spells. And now he's got Shivas. fully completed on that courier. Six slotted Storm Spirit, 46 minutes into the game, and a basher for Admiral Bulldog. In fact, that's more than a basher. That's a super basher. Abyssal Blade already completed on top of 3,800 gold. Admiral Bulldog, very rich indeed. LC, still holding on to this game though. They've got Blink Doom. They've got Chronosphere. In fact, he needs 975 mana to cast both Chronos. He doesn't have enough mana. I didn't even realize this. Does he have buyback even? He doesn't. Pretty much no buybacks for the Radiant. So even if he gets that first Chrono off, do they have mana boots on their team? Is there anyone who can give him mana? That Void is going to Time Walk Chrono, 390 mana. Then you refresh your orb and then you've got no mana left. You can maybe Time Walk again. But he's also got to activate Mask of Madness and Mjolnir. Storm jumping in Hex onto the Void. This might be his death straight away. But the Doom jumping in. Quick for baiting the BKB. Oh, and he zips away from the Chrono. Wasted there by the Faceless Void as the rest of his team are getting ripped to shreds. Sing Sing swaps the Beastmaster in. Lion has already fallen. Ember Spirit trying to do what he can. But Koikva with the plays. Baiting out BKBs, dodging Chronos. And now Admiral Bulldog going to try and expend his reincarnation. Bait some more spells. And blink away. If he can, Chrono second time, use their Doom as well. In comes the Storm Spirit, hexing up that Faceless Void. Shivas finishes them off. And there's no way back. There's no route to victory here for London Conspiracy. As they're getting systematically taken apart in Game 2 by Team Tinker. Magic Missile from Ventral Spirit finishing off that last pesky hero. Good game, well played. So that's Team Tinker taking this 2-0, racking up some points in the MLG Pro League European Division 1. I've been Durka. You can follow me on Twitter at DurkaDota or on Facebook, DurkaDota as well. Later on, I'll be casting Complexity up against Wheel in about 3.5 hours. And then UG, Union Gaming, up against Pain Gaming in about 5.5 hours for the American Division 1. So we'll have, what, a 4-hour break, something like that. And we'll catch you all later.